Half a day. My name is Maya, reporting to you from my house for Nenny News. Today, I'll be showing you how to make an apple pie. To make the pie crust, you will need 2.5 cups of flour, 1/2 tablespoon of sugar, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 pounds of cold diced butter, 6 tablespoons of water, and plastic wrap. To make the pie filling, you will need 8 tablespoons of butter, 3 tablespoons of flour, 1/4 cup of water, 1 cup of sugar, 6 to 7 green apples, 1 teaspoon of cinnamon, and to make the egg wash, you're gonna need 1 egg and 1 tablespoon of sugar. I've added my flour into a large mixing bowl. Next, I'm going to add my sugar, salt, and diced butter, and combine together with my fingertips until dissolved. Now I'm going to add 6 tablespoons of ice cold water, and then I'm going to knead it together until combined. Now I'm going to add my dough onto a clean surface, separate it into 2 balls, even balls, and create 2 even discs. Then we're going to cover them each with plastic wrap. Before we can use our pie crust, we're going to have to refrigerate them for at least 1 hour. To make the apple pie filling, I'm going to start by carefully peeling my green apples. Then I'm going to thinly slice them into slices. In a medium to small size saucepan on low to medium heat, I'm going to melt 8 tablespoons or 1 stick of butter. My butter is well dissolved. Now I'm going to add my flour and whisk until well dissolved. Okay, after our flour is well dissolved, I'm going to add our water. This consistency, or this sauce, should start to simmer. I'm going to reduce the heat and continue whisking. Now I'm going to slowly add our sugar, doing about 1 tablespoon at a time. It should have a light caramel sauce consistency. Then we're gonna allow that to cool. While waiting for our caramel sauce to cool down, I preheated the oven to 425 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay, to our thinly sliced green apples, I'm gonna add our cinnamon. And then with the large flat spatula, we want to evenly coat them in cinnamon. I'm going to roll one of my pie discs into about a 12 inch in diameter circle. I am using my fingers to help get a smoother edge. Now I'm going to transfer the dough onto the pie plate. The best way to do that I found is to roll it back on your rolling pin and then roll it back off into the pie plate. With our sauce, I'm going to use a spatula and scrape every single last drop back into our slices. Then we're going to evenly coat our slices in this sauce. Now I'm going to put them into our pie plate lined with our pie dough, slightly mounding it in the center and making sure that I'm not going to get any of the sauce or the apples from the edges, because that can make it harder to seal. I finished making my lattice. It should look somewhat like that. Then we're gonna do an egg wash so it gets a nice color on top. You wanna get this really everywhere so your whole pie has a beautiful color. Now that we're done with our egg wash, I'm going to add our pie into our 425 degree Fahrenheit oven to bake for 15 minutes. And then after the 15 minutes, you want to reduce the temperature to 350 and bake that for 45 minutes. Now this is the part where I get to bring this amazing apple pie next door to my grandpa, who enjoys eating it. Thank you for watching. Again, this is Maya reporting to you from my house. Adios.
If you would like to be featured on Nenny News to share what you are doing at home or in the community to stay healthy, happy, and safe, go to our website, manyatlu.org/nenny-news. There, you will find all the steps your parents or guardians need to take for you to be featured. We're excited to hear from you!
Cut that out. That's the extra sugar that wasn't added in.
Oh gosh. Yeah, don't record that. Trying to act like Gordon Ramsay, Mom.
I give up!